Hey guys, and welcome to my channel. If you are new, hi, welcome. My name is Anne, and if you're not, welcome back. What we do here is a lot of makeup related videos, and today we're gonna be unboxing the May BoxyCharm. So one of my BoxyCharms I did not receive for April. I've contacted them. They said there's a delay, and that was like, they emailed me like 2 weeks ago and said, rest assured that yeah, I would get it. And I ain't heard nothing else, so I emailed them and they said it'd be 2 days. I should have heard something back today and haven't. But BoxyCharm is a monthly beauty makeup subscription. This one costs $35 a month. And you get around 6 full-size products. And they do have the base box for $25 a month. That is 5 full-size products. And every 3 months, I guess it's kind of like a seasonal box. They do have the Boxy Luxe. You get around 8 products in it. And they're all full size. They are from higher end to luxury brands. And I think like beauty subscriptions is a really great way to try makeup that maybe you wouldn't buy, that you like, but you don't know if you'd want to buy it. Try new brands. Skincare, hair care, everything like that. Tools. So with the BoxyCharm, the box is always bigger than the base box. And on the inside, it is normally a different color. This is the premium, and it says premium on it. Okay, so here's the card for this month. And the theme is BoxyCharm Flowers. Flourish. Really cute. Love flowers. Okay. So, first thing I see is this by House Laboratories. I like the box. And we got Fame. Whoa. I'll break it before I get it out. Okay. So it's just like the rest of her makeup. Like, I've got some like lipsticks and liners and stuff that's got the same like kind of design. And this is their Glam Room number 1 eyeshadow palette. It is in Fame. And it looks like you're getting 2, 4, 6, 8, 10 shades in here. You get a pretty good mirror. This is a little bulkier because of this. It's small here, then it widens. Beautiful shades. And we're going to swatch these. Now, besides, I've never tried none of the eyeshadows, so I cannot wait to try this. We are going to go ahead, and this one is Cake, Applesauce, Curtain Call, Contour. And the last one in that row is Scotch. Okay. In the second row, I don't know. The second one, it's a shimmer. It didn't really, like, there's the first one, there's the second one. They didn't really show up, but they're there. They would make a really good highlighter. You can see the little pink tone to it. Flip this, and here is Spotlight, Camo, Shimmy, Slippery Room, and last one is Tot Hat, this gorgeous black. Looks pretty pigment there. The black done really, really good. Okay, so I like it. I cannot wait to try this because I've been wanting to try her eyeshadows for a while now and just haven't. Okay. Our next item is by La Rousse. They're vegan, cruelty-free, hydroallergenic. They're designed in California, made in China. I have some of their brushes. They work really good. I don't really like some, I don't know. I don't really reach for them all the time. They are good brushes. It's just that, I don't know. I think I have, like, favorite brushes already. So, in this one, we're getting 3 brush is. This looks like a highlight brush to me. This is the LR308 highlighter. It's really big, but I mean, it would really work for a highlighter. You can pat that on, blend it out. You could use it for a contour. You really use it as a blush if you wanted to. Really just use it or set underneath the eyes. Because the shape of it and the way it's like more flatter right here and rounded out. I would really like that under the eye. Okay, then we got the little liner brush. I use these more for brows. And this is the LR138 small angle. You can use it to do your eyeliner. You could use it to like put color liner on, or just like eyeshadow that you just want to do as liner. I think I'd put something like that, or maybe like brows or like drawing lines for my eyeshadow. I do that sometimes. And this looks like a powder brush. These are in the same, like, I don't have them two brushes, but the same design that I've already got from Ipsy. These are the Kabuki brush. This is the LR322. And just say, you can use that for foundation. You could use it for powder. You can use it for blush, contour, anything you want it to do. But it looks more like I think it's supposed to be a foundation brush, but I like to use stuff for whatever. Then, vitamin C. Break the cycle with Real Beauty. Vitamin C facial sheet mask. It's got pomegranate fruit extract, fig fruit extract, citrus fruit. It's hydrating, concentrating serum sheet, perfect fit, innovation, eco-friendly, sustainable material, leave it on for 10 minutes, and it's free of mineral oil, paraffins, artificial fragrance, artificial dye, MPEG, talc, silicone, phosphates, benzoyl, well, it's free of everything. And how many do you get in here? You get 5 sheets. Each one weighs 120, I don't know if they all, but one's like 125 milliliters, 4.2 ounces. And it's just a little sheet. Okay, but Beauty, and this is their Power Move Creamy Matte Lip Crayon, 1.5 grams, which is 0.05 ounces, enriched with wild African mango extract, and I got the color Red Velvet. You know, I always say that every woman should have a good red lipstick in her collection, because red can sometimes be a power move, and but I think we all have that certain red that looks good on us. Like, I don't think every red looks good on me. I like a certain tone of red, and it's just a regular lip crayon. It's got the angle just like the end. Ooh, I like it. It's like a deep, dark wine red. So, I like that. I already got I got matte lipstick on already. Okay, then we've got the Too Faced Melted Chocolate Matte Eyeshadow 24-Hour Crease-Proof, Waterproof, Long Wear. It is 4.9 milliliter, 0.16 flow ounce. Well, and It's really cute container. I love the always when companies do a little extra. They make the containers or, you know, the opponents look cuter, better. I like that. Ooh, this is pretty. I can't really smell chocolate. It is chocolate. One is the color. So I like that. I cannot wait to try that. I've never tried none of the melted chocolate eyeshadows. I have the lips. Love them. Okay. Our last item is Sermonkind. It is their Black Blossom Hand Serum. Okay, I think we all could use that right now. It's a rural skin. I wish my camera would focus a little bit better. Okay. And we are getting 50 milliliters, 1.69 flow ounces. Due to elegant and mystery color, the Black Tulip from Netherlands is a symbol of absolute beauty, royalty, and novelty. The Black Tulip is enriched with astringent, a bioactive natural flavoring that protects from external stimuli and smooths out the delicate skin on your hands. Skin formed by fortifying and balancing. It is animal tested, free and vegan. Mixed packaging. Okay. But right now, I don't know. I don't know if you guys. I always overwash my hands anyway, so I've always kept like dry hands. But ever since this COVID happened, even like my lotions that I normally use where I already overwash my hands, does not help. It's like my hands stay dry. They look like awful all the time. And I have tried everything. Now what I do, and it doesn't like keep them cured, but it does keep the, over dryness and, really looking like my hands are, 100 years old is I've been using Vaseline when I go to bed at night. I put it on my hands because I use lotion and stuff all day long, and I've used, some of the best lotions. I do scrubs. I do everything, and that's the only thing I can see right now that I found to keep actually just from over drying and itching all the time. Do good. Be kind. And it's just like a little, little aluminum. You gotta poke it. So here it is. It's just a white cream. It feels really, really good. It's got a good smell to it. I like it. I hope it works. But I'll just tell you, there's my hands really can't take much more. Put that out of the way. And so our box was $35. Our first thing, which was the Haspel Laboratory eyeshadow palette, is retailed at $34. So, you know, besides the dollar, we pretty much right there covered our box. The Too Faced Melted eyeshadow is $21. So we're already at $20 ahead. Then we have the Bite Beauty Power Move Creamy Matte Lip Crayon. It is retailed for $26. And then the Sermonkind hand lotion serum is $27. The LaRousse Beauty On The Set Go is the three-piece brush set is $96. And the Real Beauty Vitamin C facial mask, they are $15. So we did get our money back and got a lot extra. Now these brushes right here, Would I pay $96? I already have some of theirs. Brushes. I don't have these three, but I do have some of the brushes, and I'm gonna be honest, there ain't no way that I would pay $96 for these brushes. They're supposed to be like luxury brushes to me. I don't feel like they are the best brushes, and for $96 I could go to Morphe's, I could go to somewhere else and get some really good brushes that I would actually use and reach for. I'm not down in these. Like, they are good quality brushes, they're just not my favorite. I will use them, but they're just not like something I'm going to reach for a lot. I mean, it is a good box. I love getting brushes. I like Bite Beauty. I'm excited about that lip color. I really do like it because that dark red is just really pretty. Love that liquid eyeshadow. And I'm really excited to be able to try the House Beauty. Because I've been wanting to try the eyeshadows by her. And I'm really just happy with the box. So, all in all, it's a good box. I'll use everything in it. There's nothing I won't use. So, that's always a plus, is when you get a box that you know you're going to use. So, you know, none of it's wasted money. But if you don't use it, you can always gift it or something like that. But I guess that is it on the boxy. Hopefully I get my box from last month like soon, because I'm like tired of waiting on it. Looks like I know delays, but they already getting the, I already got both boxes. Like, I just now received my boxy and my boxy premium. So, you know, then why can't last month's box be shipped? It's kind of stupid. And I'm still working on, like, putting no heat or nothing to my hair. I tried to straighten it the best I could. It's not working out too good. But I guess that is it. I hope you guys liked it, this video. If you did, please give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button before you go. And I will see y'all in the next one. Bye for now.